a link between mental illness and homelessness? Takir Norman shows us that poor health could possibly lead to poverty.
And went to a clinic, and they sent me to Baton Rouge. They diagnosed me with bipolar disorder.
That's when things changed for Jeffrey McCoy. He says since his diagnosis, he has been homeless for 4 years.
I went to St. Vincent de Paul, the Bishop Ott Men's Shelter, and for 2 weeks they let me stay there, but then they turned me out.
But St. Vincent de Paul doesn't just provide shelters. They serve over 216,000 meals per year. CEO Michael Acaldo says that they can only do so much to help those with disabilities.
We want to do a lot for people in need, but often folks that suffer from mental illness, they don't want help.
Carol Green disagrees. She says that the government simply does not supply enough disability income to cover the cost of living.
The money that they give me is just paying for my rent. I still got the lights, the water, the sewage, and clothes and personal items.
The average monthly rent is $744, while the average Social Security income is $674. Since the administration won't increase funds for 2009 and 2010, some recipients feel thrown under the bridge.
Social services worker Pamela Selvage admits that funds can become so scarce that clients are forced to seek assistance elsewhere.
They need rent assistance, but we're out of funds, so we'll refer them to another agency.
But those with mental health issues who need assistance say one handout is just not enough.
The Capital Human Services District offers free screenings and counseling for anyone who may be suffering from mental illness.